Hi everyone, welcome to Technical RPA. This video we are going to discuss about what are all the new features available in Blueprism latest version. Some of the significant improvements have been achieved in Blueprism new version 6.0. That would be multiple actions in one and changes to control room and robotic screen capture. The first thing is robotic screen capture. Previously you can see in this screenshot the person, the type and detail of the current exception. This is the one it will be available in exception properties. Now they are added save screen capture. So what is the benefit of the save screen capture? In previous version of Blueprism, when a production process was thrown exception sometimes, it was difficult to determine the reasons without seeing what was happening on the screen. If any exception happened in previously, we can't see anything, but now to view the exception record, access to product runtime resources and a replay of the specific case. Blueprism has enhanced exception troubleshooting by allowing screen capture when the exception is thrown. The image is stored in the Blueprism database. The screen capture feature must be enabled in the system setting for the checkbox to take any effect. You have to enable save screen capture. Only the latest screen capture will be stored for any runtime resource. Only process running in control room will create screen captures. If you are running from your resource PC, it will not be capture the screen. If process running from control room will create screen capture. During debugging of the process, screen captures are not taken, but a message will be logged to indicate when a screen capture would have been made. So what is the benefit when using this feature? The following points should also be considered. The functionality is enabled and disabled via the system-wide setting. The second thing is screen capture can only be viewed by users with the appropriate permission. So we need the permission to check the screen captures. The screen capture functionality requires that a default encryption scheme has been configured and is valid. The fourth thing is only the latest screen capture per runtime resource will be stored. Suppose 10 screens are captured, the latest only will be stored in runtime resource. The second feature is changes to the control room. The default, so some of the warning thresholds they are added a new feature. Previously these type of warning features are not available, but now you can see default session warning time for available for all the features. Automatically backup and force users to summarize their changes, password controls and latest runtime resource screen capture and system default and overridden. For individual process and object options, warning threshold is available, both system and overridden option as well. Here you can see benefits. Improvements have been made to the control room to provide greater visibility and ease of management of the Blueprism digital workforce. The controller is now capable of applying multi-select filters to the process. Now you can see multi-select filters to the process and resources on the session grid and save as custom session views. Process and resources can be selected individually or as groups. Control room session views can be exported as reports, which facilitates ad hoc report grouping. Control room can also warn a controller if an action is taking longer than expected to complete it. Suppose you are assuming your particular action has completed in 10 seconds. So you have to mention here, after this 10 second default warning message will be available in the default session. Control room can also warn a controller if an action is taking longer than expected to complete. This allows the controller to become aware of a possibly stuck process and remediate accordingly. Previously, the controller would need to be monitoring work queues, looking for work cases that do not change their status for too long. Now the warning is displayed on the session view. Here you can see now the warning has been displayed in session view. The third and important feature is multiple actions in one. So in previous, this is the previous version, how you are implementing. This is the new version, version 6.0, how we are implementing the actions. Previously your action has, if you have one navigate stage, you are using only one action, the calculator activate application. But here you can see calculator and 1, 2, 3, 4 global mouse click center, everything you can do in the multiple actions in one navigate or else one write stages. Here you can see how it will work. Here you can see pause after each step. So after each step, what is the time span or seconds you want to queue? Suppose your activate application has been completed, then probably the next will be run after 0.5 seconds or whatever you configure in this time span. So in that case, how you can do is how you can reduce our stages is, here you can see start, clear, result, press 1, press 2, press 3, like that. So everything it will start, clear, result, add 12 to 3, end. So your action and stages will be reduced from big to small. Now you can complete your process or page within the 2 or 3 actions and stages. In previous version of Blueprism, when an arbitrary pass was required, it would involve the creation of an extra stage and a sequence of passes would result in a long chain of stages. Stages will be long chain. This was typical when using surface automation. In version 6, the navigate stage is enhanced to accommodate arbitrary passes. You can see arbitrary passes. Dynamic weight stages should still be used if a navigation stage result in change in the application. In addition to a pause between different actions, see, suppose you have calculator, SA calculator, you have elements, so you have one more option is there, interval. Here you can give the interval time span. The first one is pause after each step. The second thing is interval. So you can use both for the arbitrary weights. In addition to pause between different actions within the same navigate stage, a time interval can be defined for delay between keystrokes. This is the time interval within the same global send key actions. This can accommodate slow or poorly connected target systems where global send key functions can be unpredictable. In previous version, you would be looping through the text to send and applying a small pass. Now the version 6 functionality, it allows you for quicker development and more compact and concise process and object flow diagrams. So these are the three features will be more important one, and robot screen capture and multiple actions in one, and both are very good features which has been introduced by Blueprism. Thanks guys, thanks for watching this video.